Well, there is a total solar eclipse happening in the United States, and it's a good excuse to experience science in real life.
Rich DeMuro explains in today's Tech Smart.
A total solar eclipse is happening on April 8th, 2024. And according to the scientists at NASA, not only is it a unique experience, it's also a learning opportunity.
It's been 7 years since the last total solar eclipse in the U.S., and the next one won't happen until 2044.
Just an amazing and moving experience.
Jason Rhodes is a senior research scientist at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory. He says the Earth is a rarity because the Moon and the Sun look about the same size in our sky.
And so when the Moon passes exactly in front of the Sun, it's just large enough to block out the Sun. And that's what we call a total solar eclipse.
The natural event lets scientists study the atmosphere of the sun. But for the rest of us humans,
it was really an amazing sort of life-changing experience to watch the sun go dark and feel night happen all of a sudden, listen to the animals go silent because they're a bit confused.
Many will see a partial solar eclipse on April 8th. But if you're in the path of totality, which stretches from Texas to the Northeast, you'll get the full experience, especially if the sky is clear. If you're going to look, safety first.
The important thing is, as the eclipse is coming, you want to wear special eclipse glasses that are going to protect your eyes. Once the eclipse happens and the totality happens, you can take those glasses off because the sun is blocked.
To early humans, an eclipse was scary and unknown. Understanding them and predicting when they will happen is a win for humanity.
But one of the things in understanding the universe, it allows us to create these technologies like GPS, which make our lives better and safer.
Rhodes' advice, just enjoy it.
Just be in the moment, experience the eclipse, look at it, and I guarantee you, you will remember it for the rest of your life, whether you have a picture of it or not.
Now, I know he said to just enjoy it, but I'm sure that urge to take a picture is going to be there. So coming up in my next report, I'll explain how to safely take photos and videos of the eclipse using your smartphone. I'm Rich DeMuro, and you are Tech Smart.